Great. For question eight, the very first thing you want to do is actually find the area of the annulus. So pretending like it's whole. So you'll have 12 squared pi minus 9 squared pi. Then you're going to solve it. So you get 144 pi minus 81 pi. And then subtract 144 from 81. So you get 63 pi for the area of your annulus. Okay, so that's the total area. But then they want you to exclude this chunk here, right? The 60%, they want it to go away. So you want to find the area of what's left, which if we're dealing with a circle, that means 300 degrees out of the 360 degrees is what they want you to find. So then you multiply that by 63 pi. They do want you to keep your answers in terms of pi. So how are you going to enter this into your calculator? Okay, you're going to take the 300 over 360 in parentheses, and then times by the 63. Okay, so then you want to make sure that it's in parentheses and that you're not including pi. Okay, because we're leaving in terms of pi, so you kind of want to simplify everything without pi, and pi kind of gets put in at the end. So when you click enter, okay, you notice that you get 52.5, okay, but again, you'll notice the answer is in a fraction. So I know I've told some of you on how to find fractions in your calculator. Okay, so now that you have this decimal, you're going to go over to your math button right here. And then you're going to see where it says fraction. Okay, you're going to press enter and then enter again, and it gives you the fraction, 105 over 2. So your answer will be 105 over 2 pi centimeters squared as your final answer.